half of all member states and the high representative came together on one common platform here yesterday. This sends a strong signal that the European Union stands united for a better global future for all, particularly at a time when the values of multilateralism and solidarity with others are under threat. We have to do things differently from now on. Development is not a one-off eureka process. It is a gradual process which learns and improves across time through thousands of interactions with millions of actors across the globe. We need to be able to shift our mindsets and our actions. We need to be nimble and not take a rigid, one-size-fits-all approach. This means using all of our tools, expertise, and capacity to respond to a range of challenges in a variety of circumstances. This is what our new consensus is all about. Providing a solid basis, but giving us the flexibility to adapt to new and emerging challenges and opportunities. Like the 2030 agenda, at the heart of our new consensus are the 5 P's that you will be exploring further today in this closing panel. No one can deny that an investment in peace is also an investment in people, and vice versa. We can no longer operate in silos which overlook the many complex links between our development, humanitarian, migration, security, and climate policies. Let me be clear. This does not mean pursuing these other approaches instead of our development objectives. It means working with them, precisely because they give us the best chance of truly eradicating poverty once and for all. And because eradicating poverty is the best way to meet these other objectives too. In a similar way, we cannot continue to ruthlessly pursue greater prosperity, both collective and individual, at the expense of all else. And most importantly, of our planet and needs of future generations. This is why the new consensus emphasizes both the social, economic, and environmental dimension of sustainable development. We want to create the framework in which sustainable, inclusive, and responsible growth can thrive. Growth which is more equitable and helps to reduce, not to increase, inequalities. And we cannot reach our goals without the support of the private sector. When a socially responsible private sector meets an enabling public sector environment, this is where the magic can really happen. Because, yes, the private sector is an economic actor and an investor, but it can also be a responsible development partner. This is the whole idea behind our proposals for a new European external investment plan. Combining public finance as a loan guarantee with technical and policy support to improve the investment environment, this new plan will create investments, jobs, and growth in much needed areas and sectors in our partner countries. Increasingly, we will need to use limited resources to help improve our partner countries' capacity to deliver the 2030 agenda, which is why we will be proposing, in the context of our budget support policy, to establish sustainable development goal contract with them. This will help to improve economic stability, public finances, and domestic resource mobilization. We will also strengthen our support in the area of international tax governance to actively fight tax avoidance, tax evasion, and illicit financial flows. Success will only happen if we really manage to build stronger, better, and more diverse partnerships with countries at all levels of development and with a wider range of actors in the private sector and beyond. This is why the new consensus highlights the importance of creating the space for multi-stakeholder relations to thrive, spaces like these European Development Days, because we don't have all the answers yet. Whether it's achieving the true gender equality, preventing devastating climate change, or managing the movements of people on unprecedented scales, these are all issues beyond the gift of one government or one group of people to solve. Public and private sector, civil society and international organizations, employers and trade unions, academia, local and global actors, we have all come under this roof to offer the very best and latest ideas on how to tackle these challenges better together. But our job is not done when we walk out of these doors at the end of this day. It is only just beginning. So perhaps an overarching question to consider during our final deliberations here today is, what can we all do to move from talking the talk to ensure we are walking the walk? To come back to our central theme, it's not just about investing in development, it's about investing in all of us. As our new consensus underlines, it's about investing in our world, our destiny, our dignity, and our future. Thank you very much all for being with us these days, and let's be together.